The number of dishes is sufficient, but then it is such a monotonous variety of unstriking dishes. It is an inane, dead level of fair to middling. There is nothing to accent it. Perhaps if the roast of mutton or of beef, a big generous one, were brought on the table and carved in full view of the client, that might give the right sense of earnestness and reality to the thing. But they don't do that. They pass the sliced meat around on a dish, and so you are perfectly calm. It does not stir you in the least. Now, a vast roast turkey stretched on the broad of his back, with his heels in the air and the rich juices oozing from his fat sides, but I may as well stop there, for they would not know how to cook him. They can't even cook a chicken respectably, and as for carving it, they do that with a hatchet. This is about the customary table d'hôte bill in summer. Soup, characterless. Fish, sole, salmon, or whiting, usually tolerably good. Roast, mutton or beef, tasteless, and some last year's potatoes. A pâté or some other made dish, usually good, considering. One vegetable, brought on in state and all alone, usually insipid lentils or string beans or indifferent asparagus. Roast chicken, as tasteless as paper. Lettuce salad, tolerably good. Decayed strawberries or cherries. Sometimes the apricots and figs are fresh, but this is no advantage, as these fruits are of no account anyway. The grapes are generally good, and sometimes there is a tolerably good peach, by mistake. The variations of the above bill are trifling. After a fortnight, one discovers that the variations are only apparent, not real. In the third week, you get what you had the first, and in the fourth week, you get what you had the second. 3 or 4 months of this weary sameness will kill the robustest appetite. It has now been many months, at the present writing, since I have had a nourishing meal, but I shall soon have one, a modest private affair, all to myself. I have selected a few dishes, and made out a little bill of fare, which will go home in the steamer that precedes me, and be hot when I arrive, as follows. Radishes, baked apples with cream. Fried oysters, stewed oysters, frogs. American coffee with real cream. American butter. Fried chicken, southern style. Porterhouse steak. Saratoga potatoes. Broiled chicken, American style. Hot biscuits, southern style. Hot wheat bread, southern style. Hot buckwheat cakes. American toast. Clear maple syrup. Virginia bacon, broiled. Blue points on the half shell. Cherry stone clams. San Francisco mussels, steamed. Oyster soup. Clam soup. Philadelphia terrapin soup. Oysters roasted in shell northern style. Soft shell crabs. Connecticut shad. Baltimore perch. Brook trout from Sierra Nevadas. Lake trout from Tahoe. Sheephead and croakers from New Orleans. Black bass from the Mississippi. American roast beef. Roast turkey, Thanksgiving style. Cranberry sauce. Celery. Roast wild turkey, woodcock, canvas-back duck from Baltimore, prairie leans from Illinois, Missouri partridges, broiled, possum, coon, Boston bacon and beans, bacon and greens, southern style, hominy, boiled onions, turnips, pumpkin, squash, asparagus, butter beans, sweet potatoes, lettuce, succotash, string beans, mashed potatoes, ketchup, boiled potatoes in their skins, new potatoes, minus the skins. Early rose potatoes, roasted in the ashes, southern style, served hot. Sliced tomatoes with sugar or vinegar, stewed tomatoes. Green corn cut from the ear and served with butter and pepper. Green corn on the ear. Hot corn pone with chitlins, southern style. Hot hoe cake, southern style. Hot egg bread, southern style. Hot light bread, southern style. Buttermilk, iced sweet milk. Apple dumplings with real cream, apple pie, apple fritters, apple puffs, southern style, peach cobbler, southern style, peach pie, American mince pie, pumpkin pie, squash pie, all sorts of American pastry.